What's going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to be showing off 10 things that pros do that you don't. I went back and watched VODs and recent gameplay from the best pros in the world. I try to look for common plays that pros do that I rarely ever see an average player doing. Hopefully you can learn some moves that are coming off from this video and you can become an even better player. With that being said, let's jump right in. Right here we have gameplay from PeterBot, Poyo, and Polarized. What they are doing here is layered and diagonal box fighting, which are the best ways to fight if you are trying to play in a more defensive and safe way. I have a YouTube short that gives an in-depth understanding on how to do this correctly. A couple things you need to know is to make sure you reset the edit before the opponent takes a shot on you, and to only take a peek when you're actually going to take a shot. The only time that you don't have to do this peek is when someone is low, just like what Polarized is doing here. In these clips here, I am showing off how to do something called predicted piece control. I'm sure someone in the game has done this to you. All you have to do is hold your right hand peek and place two cones and then a wall. I like to do this edit because it gives me enough space to shoot the opponent. Also, I recommend going straight to your AR or SMG right after to finish the opponent. In Fortnite, it is so beneficial to have retakes because they give the opportunity for you to regain high ground during a build battle. I have a video on 3 retakes that you guys can learn. Mechanics also are very important in Fortnite because they are a huge factor in your overall gameplay. This allows you to outmaneuver opponents, secure high ground, and win fights. Since Fortnite is so fast-paced, this will truly help you win fights. This clip by Polarized here is an example on why mechanics are so important in Fortnite. Phasing into boxes can be a high-risk, high-reward situation depending on how good you are at it. It all comes down to being unpredictable, fast, and having a good execution to it. I wouldn't use this phase trick because right as you place that ramp, instantly the opponent will know what you're trying to do. My favorite one is where you jump in randomly. It is very hard to tell when someone is doing it in-game because it happens so fast and comes out of nowhere. It doesn't matter what weapon it is when you are phasing through. This map is absolutely perfect for practicing this. If someone is ever trying to phase in your box like this, just do a cone edit and it will block them from entering your box. Playing smart is something that isn't noticed in the right way. When I say you have to play smart, I mean that you have to play in a way that you know exactly what to do in the right situation. This is to make sure that you do this right every time as well. It is likely that when you're in a match, you might not be focused. We just play the game in a fun way, but if you are really trying to play better, then you need to know these 3 essential needs. Number 1, make sure that you quickly loot, because there can be another player that has just landed in the same building as you, and you need to find a weapon so you have the advantage in that fight. That weapon could be a shotgun that you know you will need. Number 2, this is quite similar to number 1, which is making sure you have a good drop, because this can be the reason for dying if someone else has a better drop than you. Or if you land on the same chest as someone else and it's a 50-50 on who gets the gun first, those extra seconds on having a better drop mean a lot. Especially in the competitive scene, I recommend if you play keyboard and mouse to use scroll wheel pickup. I use it and it's super helpful for picking up guns first. Number 3, engage in fights wisely. Just be careful considering factors like your health, shield, loot, and resources, and position relative to your opponent. This tip right here will have 2 parts, and it's about being unpredictable. First is one where you can have a double edit, like this, and the other player is like this. They get double edited on. It's very predictable when you edit it just like that, and try to shoot, but they can just pre-fire you from this side like that. So what you want to do instead is double edit and then wall, window edit, right there, and then peek.
This is what it might look like.
Someone is ever in a box and they don't have a cone like that. They don't have a cone. Once you take that wall, you edit Mongrel Classic, reset it, do a window edit, and then peek and then reset. All right, let's say I'm on about half health and I have minis, so I have heals, and also I have enough mats. For this, let's use metal. You wanna use hard mats, either brick or metal. And you're gonna make one box, another box, another box, and another box. What a player might do is they're gonna be, if you're low, they're gonna rush you like this. So what you wanna do is get ready, shoot them like a pre-fire kind of right as they break that wall, and then go to another box and start healing. This just gives you enough space to, you know, fight the opponent, and you can also heal as well. They're not gonna wanna fight you if you have that many boxes. I mean, if you see someone with full metal like this, it's just gonna be annoying to fight them, like breaking this, and then you can just go to a different box afterwards.
I think having good aim is more important than having good mechanics. There are many pros that don't do aim training creative maps, but they do Kovacs. It costs money, but it is very helpful to build up better aim over time. If you aren't willing to spend money like that, then you can go do aim training in normal creative maps. I have two of the best creative maps to help your aim. This one is helpful for close fighting. I really only use this map for practicing when someone is in my box. This one is helpful for medium and long range. I usually use this one to practice my SMG hipfire accuracy and my sniper accuracy. Just practice your aim for about 5 to 10 minutes every day because you don't want to do it too long or else it'll get boring fast. To get consistently good ping, what you will want is an Ethernet cable. Do not use Wi-Fi. You must use Ethernet. All platforms can use this as well. You will drastically see your ping drop and your ping will never go up to 100 or more again. Use a Cat5 or Cat6 cable, and you must not use a Cat7 or Cat8. The link will be in the description to buy. Now, if your router is far away, then what you can do is purchase a power line adapter. All you have to do is plug one of the adapters into your router and the other adapter into your gaming device. By the way, you do not have to buy two of these. Now for the last tip, what you must have is good peripherals. Better peripherals can cause less input delay and a lot better gameplay. I recommend keyboard and mouse players to get an Apex Pro TKL and Logitech G Pro Superlight. For controller players, I recommend the SCUF Infinity 4 PS Pro for PlayStation, and for Xbox players, I recommend the Xbox Elite Series 2 controller. Thank you guys for watching the entire video. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one.